Hey, good people. Hope you're having a great night. Wanted to hop on and talk to you about the importance of watching your close friendships in your personal life and the influence that they are having on you, whether it's a good influence or a bad influence. Amen. So I wanted to start off by talking about the book of Deuteronomy. And this is kind of actually a theme that we see all throughout the Old Testament. I'm just throwing out Deuteronomy because it's one of the books that it's in. And one thing that God did with the Israelites a lot is he told them, he said, this specific people group, do not intermarry with this specific people group. And you know, you might go, well, why would God say such a thing? It had less to do with other factors and more to do with the fact that a lot of times these other people groups were involved in worshiping false gods, in idolatry, or in just straight up rebellion against God. Amen. And so God specifically told the Israelites, do not yoke yourself to these people groups, because if you do, they're going to lead you astray. Amen. And you know, God is a perfect example for us to follow in terms of our friendships and our relationships. Jesus is the best model. Here we go. What was Jesus's model? Jesus's model was he loved and outreached to everybody. Everybody he loved on outreach to. However, he guarded his close friend group a little more carefully. He surrounded himself, those people who were the biggest confidants in his life were people like the disciples. You guys, people who were on fire for the Lord, people who were wanting to learn more and to grow in their walk with Christ. Amen. And you know, I think that it's so important for us to make sure that we are, for our close confidants, surrounding ourselves with those that we want to become more like one day. Amen. That are inspiring us to get closer in our walk with the Lord. You know, I think that a lot of the times we take on the characteristics of our closest friendships. Have you noticed that before? You'll start to even, if you hang out around someone for a few years, you'll even start to use their language. I've noticed myself starting to do that. There were phrases I never said before I had a couple of the friends in my life. And then all of a sudden, because they said those phrases all the time, I started picking them up. Right? Because our close friendships, those people that we commune with on a regular basis, they really do rub off in our lives. And so that's why God's warning was so strong to the Israelites. He was like, don't even consider intermarrying with these people. Don't even consider mingling in this sin, because there's a chance if you do that, you could get sucked in too. And that's not good, you guys. And I would encourage you, especially in your relationships, y'all, there's a reason in the Bible why God says, do not be unequal yoked. Don't marry an unbeliever. Amen. Because this stuff can rub off and it can cause you to fall in your personal life. I've talked to so many people who are like, well, I can be strong. It's not a big deal. I've got a lot of Christian friends in my life. So, I mean, I'll be fine as long as they respect that my beliefs are my beliefs. You guys, the Bible talks about this for a reason, you know, and if the Israelites weren't strong enough, we're not strong enough either a lot of the time, you guys. And so I want you guys to take inventory over your friendships tonight and ask yourself the question, are my primary closest friends in my life, are they leading me closer to the heart of the Father, or are they leading me farther away from his love? And if your honest answer is, God, I got a lot of friendships that are, you know, leading me away from you. What you can do is pray a prayer and say, Lord, send friendships into my life that are going to lead me closer to your heart. And, you know, I did this prayer a few years ago. A lot of you guys have heard me talk about this before, but I basically, God prompted me to pray a prayer. I didn't really want to pray it. And he basically prompted me to pray and to say, Lord, I pray that you would remove the people from my life who are not supposed to be there and bring in the people who are supposed to be there. And to be honest, he removed a lot of the people that I'd never in a million years thought would be removed, or he'd ask me to remove them. And then a lot of the times he would keep people that I thought should have been removed, you know? And so that just goes to show you that God's ways are higher than our ways and he knows what's best. Amen. He discerns people's heart motives. He knows where you're headed. He knows what's best for you over your personal circumstances. So, all of that to say, are your friendships leading you closer to the heart of the Father or farther away from his love? If they're leading you farther away, pray for God to send you some friendships that are gonna lead you closer to him, because he cares about that area of your life and he wants you to be surrounded by faithful stewards of the gospel. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.